Howdy folks, how you doing? You know, around December, 1st of December, something like that, I posted a video about my pipe tampers, my first pipe tamper, and unfortunately after I posted I became very ill and was not able to do any videos for a while, a month and a half, something like that, and it's really a shame because it was around Christmas and some other really bad things happened during that Christmas, one of which I'll talk about in the future. And it's too bad because I had some really cool videos planned. I had a Christmas video planned that would have been pretty funny, I think, and kind of a neat thing. And then I wanted to make a video telling Pipler thank you for the wonderful Christmas card, but I wasn't in any shape to do any of that. So, and then by the time that was all getting ending, the camera that I use actually broke. So I was no longer able to even make videos because of that too. And then when I got a new camera, I had this video series about my pipe tampers I wanted to post, but they were from the old camera, which wasn't very good quality, frankly. And since my new camera takes videos in high def, I thought I'd remake the videos about my pipe tampers, and I'll start with my first pipe tamper, which is right there. This is my first pipe tamper ever. I bought this thing like 26 years ago, something like that, a long time ago. Bought it at my local tobacco shop. And there's the tamper part in the bottom. Has a little thing here. Goes in the shirt pocket, which is very handy because I have a pipe bag I use to put my pipe stuff into, and it's very handy to be able to actually, you know, slip that in there. And how it works is you unscrew it, this little part here, you unscrew that, and put this down here so you can look. It'll work, and what happens is the thing all unfolds. It comes out of here, it all unfolds. There's a little knife on there, and there's a poker, a little poke, and then there's a tamper still, so you can use this, you know, in your pipe, you know, you can, even when it's out of the little case, you know. Problem I have with it is I tend to, you know, have it sitting around and grab it, you know, and I grab it to tamp my pipe, and I end up doing this kind of stuff, you know, and I don't care for that. I value my pipes, as most of you know, quite a bit. So I wanted to get a new pipe tamper, and I just kind of probably wanted to buy something, too, for that matter. And that's what I did. So this is my first pipe tamper. I still use this actually when I go outside to smoke. This is my go-to pipe tamper. And when I travel anywhere, I use this pipe tamper because it's not my best one. It's not my nicest one. This I think I paid like $2 for. I've seen them on eBay, pretty much brand new, for $10. But even though they're still used, but for what I paid for it not long time ago, $2, it was a good deal. I thought, you know, it's been real nice. It's been cheap and usable and workable. And it's still in pretty good shape because I try to take care of myself. So that's my first pipe tamper. And what I'll do is I will continue this series, and there'll be several more parts showing my other pipe tampers. I have some really interesting ones that I really, really like, which you might find interesting too. So there you go, folks. All right. This is Kelly signing off.